What is going on, everybody? Today is the day that we go through my entire 4K Ultra HD collection, all the films that I own on 4K, all in one video. Thank you for coming back to the channel. It's been about a year since we did this, and as you can see, a lot has changed since last time. I'm in a new space, and then I have a whole lot more titles to go through. So without further ado, let's just get right into it. Starting the top left, just like last time with my Disney Pixar collection. Starting right here at Toy Story, we got these in release order right here. Followed by A Bug's Life, Toy Story 2, Monsters, Inc., Finding Nemo, The Incredibles, Cars, Ratatouille, WALL-E, Up, Toy Story 3, Cars 2, Brave, Monsters University, Inside Out, The Good Dinosaur, Finding Dory, Cars 3, Coco, The Incredibles 2, Toy Story 4, Onward is the Target exclusive version. We have Soul right here, followed by Luca, Turning Red. Now we have our standard Disney animation films like Tangled, Wreck-It Ralph, Ralph Breaks the Internet, Big Hero 6, Zootopia right here. This is Moana, Frozen, followed by Frozen 2, Raya and the Last Dragon, Encanto, which I don't believe I had last time, and Ron has gone wrong. There it is. So that's the Disney section. Now moving on to like the Disney conglomerate section. This is the Marvel Cinematic Universe right here. Also in release order, starting with, of course, the first Iron Man film, The Incredible Hulk, Iron Man 2, Thor, Captain America, The First Avenger, The Avengers, Iron Man 3, Thor, The Dark World, Guardians of the Galaxy, Captain America, The Winter Soldier, Avengers, Age of Ultron, Ant-Man, Civil War, Captain America, of course, Doctor Strange, with Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, Spider-Man Homecoming, Thor Ragnarok, Black Panther, Avengers Infinity War, Ant-Man and the Wasp with this cool lenticular slip. We have Captain Marvel and Avengers Endgame, and that is the Infinity Saga. We keep going, of course. This is Spider-Man Far From Home, Black Widow, Shang-Chi, Eternals, Spider-Man No Way Home, Doctor Strange and Multiverse of Madness, Thor Love and Thunder, Black Panther Wakanda Forever, and Ant-Man Quantumania right here, and then of course as soon as I get Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, that'll slip in right there. Now we have like our Marvel adjacent films. These are the Sony titles like Venom, sequel Venom Let There Be Carnage. Here's Morbius, which has a slipcover too cool for its own right. Lenticular, of course. Here is Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, and then recently picked up Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. Very good. Deadpool. Now we're into like the 20th century section. Deadpool 2. We do have the first three X-Men films right here. Don't have the I guess they're prequels, technically, the first three. Do not have those as of yet. This is Spider-Man, the three-film collection with Tobey Maguire. And this is the Amazing Spider-Man two-film collection with Andrew Garfield. All right, that does it for all my Marvels. Now we're moving on to DC, as we can see. Starting with Man of Steel, still sticking with release order as much as we can. That's Batman v Superman, Dawn of Justice. The Ultimate Edition, followed by Suicide Squad, Wonder Woman, Justice League, directed by Joss Whedon, Aquaman, Shazam, Birds of Prey, Wonder Woman 1984, the Justice League, Zack Snyder's Justice League, The Suicide Squad, Black Adam, and then what else is that? We have Fury of the Gods and The Flash. I'll pick those up if I feel like it, but I have not been super invested in the DC universe as of late. It's kind of is what it is. Of course, in the universe that I am invested in is this new Batman series we have going, starring Robert Pattinson. Super into that film. Can't wait for the next ones to hit theaters. And then, of course, we got to take a trip back to the 80s, the original Batman, 1989, and then 1992's Batman Returns, followed by Batman Forever, and lastly, Batman and Robin. Here's Batman the Killing Joke. I'm not super duper into the DC animated films, but Mask of the Phantasm Batman that has been recently released, and I definitely will be picking that one up for sure. So at least two DC animated films will be on my shelves for sure. This is a Batman v Superman steelbook. It kind of has like Batman on one side and then Henry Cavill's Superman on the other side. I think it's just a Blu-ray, but I saw it for a good deal one day, and I really like the artwork on that. I just kind of keep it for collector's purposes. All right, last column in this first row right here is kind of like my one man against the world universe, and then some other kind of odds and ends as of now. So we do have the Daniel Craig James Bonds with Casino Royale, Quantum of Solace, Skyfall, Spectre, No Time to Die. And now we have the Jack Ryan films all individually, starting with The Hunt for Red October, Patriot Games, Clear and Present Danger, all stickered up, Some of All Fears, and then Jack Ryan Shadow Recruit, equally stickered up. This is just a box set for the Bourne films, which includes Identity, Supremacy, Ultimatum, Legacy, and Jason Bourne. Right there, got a cool shot of Matt Damon. This is just a standard slip version of Dune, not where it appears, you know, in alphabetical order. Of course, this is a duplicate because I just imagine I'll be watching the disc a lot, and it's probably just good to have a duplicate just in case anything happens to it. I still have a cool minty copy. These are the four Leica films that Shout Factory released on 4K with Paranorman. I'll definitely be watching that in October. Got Box Trolls, Kubo and the Two Strings, and then another October watch right here from Coraline, of course. All four Leica films that have been released on 4K. So that's cool to own. And then I think these are just a couple of Harry Potter slips. I gotta figure out what to do with those at some point. But then, yeah, that is the first row. That's kind of like the cinematic universe collections that I have going on. And now we go alphabetical. So this right here is where the alphabetical order starts. And if you're like me, your favorite letters are numbers. We got numbers right here to start everything off, starting with, of course, 8 Mile, starring Eminem, followed by 13 Hours, 47 Ronin, 65 with Adam Driver, just got released this year. I gave this watch a couple days ago. Really not that big of a fan of it. I wish there's a little more to chew on in terms of plot and everything, but I thought Adam Driver did a good job for what he was given. So I think I'm gonna keep it in the collection. I like dinosaurs and stuff, but I had higher expectations before the film was released. Once it was released, I heard it wasn't super duper awesome. So I just waited to get it on 4K, and I can confirm, unfortunately, it's not super duper awesome. Kind of is what it is. 300, if we continue. 310 to Yuma. 1917. We have 2001 A Space Odyssey in this cool slip box. 2012. Accountant, The Accountant. Ad Astra. Air Force One. Akira, also in this cool slip box. Alien. Alita Battle Angel. Ambulance, had a really good time with this. This is the newest Michael Bay film with Jake Gyllenhaal. Had a really good time with it. I thought it was like kind of, I was invested in the story, and you know, the action's kind of like balls to the wall a little bit, but I was invested the whole time. It was a really, really good watch. I recommend Ambulance if you haven't seen it yet. Followed by American Assassin. Here's where all the Americans start. American Gangsta. American Made and American Psycho on Steelbook. Excited to open that whenever I decide to watch American Psycho again. Now we have Amsterdam. I wanted so much more out of this film than what we received. Not super investing story. I think kind of too many characters for its own good. I thought three leads that you see on the cover did a good job, but really just not, didn't come together as like a compelling film, in my opinion. And then we have Annihilation to finish off that section of the shelf. Now we have Apocalypse Now, this cool little box set that they came out with a few years ago. Apollo 13, Argo, Arizona, Arrival, Assassin's Creed, found like a really good deal from Best Buy. It was like $6, you know, sealed with slipcover. Couldn't really go wrong. There's Atomic Blonde, the long-awaited first Avatar from 2009, and its sequel, Avatar Way of Water. I love how they're doing the spines. I hope they continue that throughout however many sequels they're making. That'd be cool to like have all those on the shelf one day. Baby Driver, Babylon. If you haven't seen this, I recommend at least seeing it once. I haven't seen a director get so much money and so much creative freedom to just make a crazy, crazy film like this. Definitely a film that you will not forget after watching. Definitely not Chazelle's like most polished or like best by any means, but he swung for the fences on it, and that's worth some admiration for sure. So check out Babylon if you haven't seen it. This is Backdraft. Bad Guys, The Bad Guys, Bad Times at the El Royale, Battleship, Batman Begins, The Dark Knight, and The Dark Knight Rises, of course commonly known as The Dark Knight Trilogy. This is Belly, starring Nas and DMX. Beverly Hills Cop, its sequel, Beverly Hills Cop 2. Billy Lynn's Long Halftime Walk. Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds, Black Hawk Down, Black Klansman, Blade Runner The Final Cut, and its sequel, Blade Runner 2049, one of the best sequels that I've ever seen. Braveheart, Bridge Over the River Kwai, The Bridge on the River Kwai, gotta say it correctly. Brightburn, Bullet Train, Bumblebee, The Cabin in the Woods, Call of the Wild. Here's an individual release of Call Me By Your Name, or it didn't come out as an individual release, but I got the, someone was piecing out the Sony Picture Classics collection, so I picked out Call Me By Your Name for sure. Probably my favorite film in that whole collection. This is Casablanca, Martin Scorsese's Casino, Central Intelligence, Chaos Walking, Chappie, It's the Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown, A Charlie Brown Thanksgiving, and of course, A Charlie Brown Christmas, with A Clockwork Orange to finish off things on that section. Steven Spielberg's Close Encounters of the Third Kind. We have the first Cloverfield and 10 Cloverfield Lane. This is Cold Pursuit with Liam Neeson. Collateral, in my opinion, Michael Mann's best film, even over Heat. Don't At Me. We have Cool Hand Luke, Crank, Creed movies, which I really, really enjoy. Get a lot of good times with. Creed 2, and released this year, Creed 3. Crimes of the Future, Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, The Da Vinci Code, Angels and Demons, and lastly, Inferno. This is The Dark Tower, The Darkest Hour, Days of Thunder, Death on the Nile, Deepwater Horizon, Die Hard, District 9. Now we have, I'm guessing I put Ex Machina probably over here or something, so let's wait till alphabetical order gives you your turn. We have the Divergent trilogy right here, starting with the titular film Insurgent and Allegiant. This is Dr. Sleep. We have Don't Worry Darling, of course it's the Blu-ray slip, but up in there is indeed the 4K copy. I had a really good time with this film. Didn't get a whole lot of, you know, award nominations or anything like that, but if you didn't watch the film because of that, I recommend giving it a good time, or giving it the time of day. I think you may have a good time with it like I did. Florence Pugh and Harry Styles, I think, do a pretty good job with that. We have Bram Stoker's Dracula, Dracula Untold, Dread. Now here's the Dune Steelbook. This is the copy that I keep in alphabetical order. It looks really, really cool in my opinion. Probably collect all the Steelbooks for the Dune movies. I cannot wait till it's released, even though it is now pushed back to March instead of this November. You know, I'll wait as long as it takes, as long as it's good. That's what I always say. Dunkirk. Followed by Edge of Tomorrow. Elf. Elvis. Elysium. Ender's Game. The Equalizer. The Equalizer 2. Escape Plan. Everest. Everything Everywhere All at Once. The Evil Dead. Evil Dead 2. Of course, Army of Darkness. Had to put that in there. You know, I can't break those up. Now is probably where Ex Machina goes. So just imagine that right there. Probably kept it out so these can kind of flow a little nicely. I can pick them out nicely. This is the Expendable trilogy. Expendables, Expendables 2, and Expendables 3. Hitchcock's Family Plot. Now we have the entire Fast and Furious collection right here with The Fast and the Furious, Too Fast, Too Furious, Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift, Fast and Furious, Fast 5, Fast and Furious 6, Furious 7, Fate of the Furious, F9, The Fast Saga, and the newly released Fast X or Fast 10, whichever you prefer. Now we have The Fifth Element. Kind of adjust how I'm holding this thing right here. This is First Man, literally me on the moon. Forrest Gump. Ford v Ferrari. Frosty the Snowman. Stanley Kubrick's Full Metal Jacket, followed by Fury. Gattaca. And in 60 frames per second, Gemini Man. So that does it for the first row of alphabetical. Moving right along. All right, moving right along, we do have Get Out right here. We do have the animated Ghost in the Shell, as well as the live action Ghost in the Shell. This is Giant with James Dean. The Girl on the Train. Gladiator. Glass. The Godfather Trilogy 1, 2, and 3, as well as Coda, all in 4K. This is Godzilla, Kong Skull Island, Godzilla King of the Monsters, and then Godzilla vs. Kong, and then anything else that comes out in the Monsterverse will probably just be right there. Goodfellas, The Greatest Showman, this is The Green Knight, The Green Mile, Hacksaw Ridge. We have Halloween 1978, and then Halloween 2018, Halloween Kills, and Halloween Ends from last year. This is Hancock. And now we have the entire Harry Potter universe, at least as it stands right now, with Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, The Chamber of Secrets, Prisoner of Azkaban, The Goblet of Fire, The Order of the Phoenix, Half-Blood Prince, Deathly Hallows Part 1, and Deathly Hallows Part 2. That would be Fantastic Beast movies and Where to Find Them, Crimes of Grindelwald, and Secrets of Dumbledore, followed by Michael Mann's Heat. This is Hell or High Water. We have Hellboy and Hellboy 2. Hereditary, Hidden Figures, The Hitman's Bodyguard, and The Hitman's Wife's Bodyguard. My mistake. We have the anthology film Hobbs and Shaw, still Fast and Furious presents right there. We have Home Alone, always a good holiday watch. Have a fun time with that this Christmas season. This is Hostels, Hot Fuzz, and How to Train Your Dragon, the original, How to Train Your Dragon 2, and How to Train Your Dragon, The Hidden World. This is all four Hunger Games films that include, of course, The Hunger Games, Catching Fire, Mockingjay Part 1, and Mockingjay Part 2. This is Hurricane Heist, followed by Hustlers, In the Line of Fire with Clint Eastwood, Inception. Finally, have the Indiana Jones films. Been a while, or it's been a long time coming, but these are some of my favorite films to watch. Raiders of the Lost Ark, Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom, Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade, and then I'm an apologist for this movie, Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. I think it's like a 7, and I don't think it deserves anything less than like a 7 out of 10. I really think it's fine. Inglourious Basterds, essential. Interstellar, equally essential. The Invisible Man. We have a couple IP Man films right here. I've yet to watch either of them or any film in the IP Man franchise. So this is the second one right here. They do have 3 and 4 on 4K. I love Donnie Yen. I love him in Rogue One and the most recent John Wick film. Like, I'd be down to see Donnie Yen kick some butt. So I think eventually one of these days I'm going to open those and see if I want the latter two on 4K as well. One day. This is It, as well as It Chapter 2, Jack Reacher, Jack Reacher Never Go Back, Jaws with his cool lenticular little slip box, John Wick, the original, John Wick Chapter 2, John Wick Chapter 3, Parabellum, and then had the title for this, dropped the title for this one. This is just straight up John Wick Chapter 4 with this amazing lenticular slipcover. I believe this was an Amazon exclusive. This is straight up beautiful. You know, I think the steelbook is great and all, but this really just sells what kind of vibe the film had, at least for me. All those scenes taking place in Japan are just absolutely beautifully lit. Love the cinematography and really all of those films. It really is a step above for action filmmaking. Anyway, enough of me gushing. We got Jojo Rabbit right here. Joker. Jumanji, the first one. Do have the Jungle Cruise. Actually, pretty good time, in my opinion. This is Jupiter Ascending. We have all of the Jurassic Park films. Jurassic Park, The Lost World, Jurassic Park 3, Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, and Jurassic World Dominion. This is Knives Out. This is Knowing with Nicolas Cage. This is La La Land. Labyrinth. Last Duel. Last Night in Soho. Lego Movie. Lego Movie 2, the second part, haha. And then Lego Batman movie. I feel like these are the only three Lego movies I need. Let me know if like I should pick up the Ninjago film, or I forget if there's another Lego movie that they've made that's made it to 4K. Let me know if you like any of the other Lego films, but for now, I'm cool with these three and sticking with them. We have Leon, the professional. Just picked up Les Mis. My significant other really, really had a good time with this film. Whenever she caught in theaters, I've personally never seen it. But I love Hugh Jackman, so can't wait to see it one day. We have Life, The Lincoln Lawyer, Logan, Lone Survivor, Looper, love this film. We have The Hobbit Trilogy, and Lord of the Rings Trilogy. I still have yet to see any of these movies on 4K. As you can see, these things are still sealed. I've seen them all plenty of times, but one of these days I need to break them out on 4K. It will happen one of these days. The Lost Boys, we'll be definitely watching that this October. Lost City. Lucy. Got some Mad Max sequels right here. This is the Road Warrior. And then we have Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome. We will catch the original later. and then one of the best action films ever made, in my opinion, Mad Max Fury Road. I will never forget when I saw that in theaters. It might have been like the first rated R movie I saw in theaters, so I'm not super, super old. It came out in 2015. Yeah, my whole family loved it, including myself. This is the Maltese Falcon. Always loved some film noir on 4K. The Martian, this is the extended version. Marnie. The Mask of Zorro. The Matrix. Matrix Reloaded. The Matrix Revolutions. And I think those three are the only Matrix films that have ever been made. Only those three. Do not correct me in the comments. This is the Maze Runner trilogy. Maze Runner, Maze Runner Scorch Trials, and The Death Cure. This is The Mechanic. I have no idea what this movie's about. I saw it for like $4 on Mercari, so one of these days I think I'll check it out. I would love some Statham. Speaking of Statham, The Meg. This is the Men in Black trilogy. I kind of love this packaging. It's like a soft touch box, and then this is like foil. I think those are the only three Men in Black films ever made. Feel free to not correct me in the comments once again. Midway. We have the Mission Impossible films with the first one. Mission Impossible 2. Mission Impossible 3. Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol. Rogue Nation. This is Fallout. And then to finish things off, Monty Python's The Meaning of Life. Really just all kinds of genres mixed together whenever you do alphabetical order. That does it for this row. Catch me in the next one. You guys still with me over here? We're definitely more than halfway done. Stick with me. Props to you for making it this far in the first place. This is Moonfall. Mortal Kombat. The Mule. Here's the first Mummy, the individual release. And then the Scorpion King, the individual release. I'm trying hard to get the two sequels in the individual release, but those slipcovers are long gone. And when they come up on the secondary market, I don't want to pay for them. So we'll see if they ever do come up. But one Mummy that is pretty easy to find is the Tom Cruise one. So I have that one too. Is Murder on the Orient Express. My Fair Lady. I love a pink spine, pink slipcover. That's cool. You don't see that too often. This is Nobody, one of my favorite action films to just throw on. Such an interesting vibe, you know, this film kind of has throughout it. And Bob Odenkirk really just kill it as a badass in that film. This is Nope with the cool horse eye slipcover. I was a huge fan of that. Speaking of things I'm a huge fan of, The Northman. This is Now You See Me. And then I don't know why they called this Now You See Me 2. The worst sequel name ever. It's Now You See Me, Now You Don't. Super easy. And they biffed it. But anyway, this is Oblivion. Pretty good film. If you like Tom Cruise and you like sci-fi, I mean, that's a really well done film right there. Same director as the newest Top Gun. So good time, in my opinion. This is Old. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. This is Operation Fortune, and then some stuff that's not in English, so I will not butcher it. This is Overlord. Pacific Rim, the good one. Pacific Rim, the bad one, also known as Uprising. Passengers. The Patriot. This is the first Pirates film, which I hear is a god-awful transfer. And then here is, I believe, the last Pirates film, Dead Men Tell No Tales. We do not have any of the middle films on 4K, at least not here in the States at the moment. We'll see if that changes anytime soon. This is Plane. Just recently picked this up. Haven't watched it yet. I hear it's pretty decent for like the recent onslaught of Gerard Butler films that have been coming out. So I'll definitely check that out at some point. We have the Planet of the Apes trilogy. I love this box set. We have a Backwards Polar Express. Definitely be breaking that out this Christmas season. This is Poltergeist, The Post, The Prestige, Prometheus, Psycho, Pulp Fiction, finally released on 4K. I'm kind of digging the black and white slipcover. I was kind of bummed at first because it wasn't like the full color version with all the really saturated colors, but I'm kind of liking the unique black and white take on it. This looks like Puss in Boots, the sequel. Here's the original. I don't know what's going on here. I obviously did not prepare adequately for this, this 4K update. But here's the original Puss in Boots from the early 2010s, and then The Last Wish, which got released last year. Here's the Punisher films, the original Punisher and then Punisher Warzone. I watched these and kind of had a good time with them. I really only picked this last one up because the slipcover is really rare. And it was cool just to have. But I gave these both a watch. And for, you know, your rated R comic book films, I think they're pretty decent time. Not going to lie. I thought they'd be much worse. But they weren't. And this is Push with Chris Evans. Queen and Slim. That was a really good film. Quick and the Dead. A Quiet Place. Sequel, A Quiet Place Part 2. This is my Rambo film, starting with First Blood. Rambo First Blood Part 2, Rambo 3, Rambo, and Rambo Last Blood. This is Ready Player One, Rear Window, newly released Rebel Without a Cause, Red, Red 2, Red Sparrow, Revenants. I believe I showed this off last time, but it definitely is the 4K version, even though it's the Blu-ray slipcover. Same with Reminiscence. I kind of am down for sci-fi. This is kind of like, not post-apocalyptic, but, you know, like all the ice is melted and, you know, like every city is like underwater and stuff. But then that's kind of just the world building. There's a lot that goes on with this. I thought this was decent. Yeah, this was both Blu-ray slipcovers and then... But I really want to get technical. This Prometheus one is too. But trust me, it's the 4K. I'm not lying to you guys. Promise. So we just went over Reminiscence. This is Requiem for a Dream. Reservoir Dogs. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Saboteur. Sausage Party. Saving Private Ryan. I have the two like black and gold films right next to each other that work out. Scarface and Schindler's List. Both Universal releases too, so they look really nice whenever they're together. Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. Just gave this a watch last night. Reminds me why I love film. I just love the zany, wacky editing in that. Edgar Wright is an amazing director. Now we have the Scream film, which I will be watching all of them come this October. I have not seen a single Scream film. Can you believe it? So, did my research, did my homework, and I guess did my preparation, and bought everything on 4K that's available. So, Scream, Scream 2, Scream that came out last year, Scream that came out this year, and then I have a couple of the other films on Blu-ray, just standard Blu-ray. Serenity, Shadow of a Doubt, Shaun of the Dead. This is a Shawshank Redemption Steelbook. I really, really love the artwork on that. The Shining, Shrek the First, Shrek the Second, Shrek the Third will be added to my shelf soon, on 4K that is, Sherlock Holmes, Shutter Island, Sicario, Sicario Day of the Soldado, Singing in the Rain, Sisu, Skyscraper, and Smile. On 4K, just like every other film that we've gone over. Starting with this row, or I guess this is a column, this is Sonic the Hedgehog and its sequel. Sonic the Hedgehog, just two, Sonic 2. This is Source Code, Stanley Kubrick's Spartacus, Speed. Here's an interesting release. This is a steelbook for Spine, The Spine of Night, which is a animated film from RLJE, definitely like an adult animated film, not for kids. Kind of like takes place in like fantasy times, but it's all, for those who know, rotoscoped animation, which means like, I think they filmed like the basic like movements of people and then the animators animated over like that footage. And then that's the film that we see as like the animated stuff. So it's a very unique
take on animation. It's really, really cool. And a very interesting film if you haven't seen it. I would check out The Spine of Night if you ever get the chance. Split. This is A Star is Born. We have the Star Trek films, the J.J. Abrams ones. I do not have any of the originals because I really don't have any nostalgia for those. But let me know if I should pick those up. That was the first one. This is Into Darkness. And this is Star Trek Beyond. And then, of course, can't have Star Trek without having Star Wars. This is The Phantom Menace. Attack of the Clones. Revenge of the Sith. Solo, A Star Wars Story. Rogue One. A New Hope. The Empire Strikes Back. Return of the Jedi. The Force Awakens. The Last Jedi. And then The Rise of Skywalker. Followed by Star Troopers. Coming over here, we have Step Brothers. Still Alice from that same Sony Picture Classics collection that Call Me By Your Name is from. Excuse the fingers. Just kind of getting readjusted here. Then we have Stuber. Straight Outta Compton. This is a recent upgrade. Had it on Blu-ray and I found a 4K copy. Super 8. Released earlier this year. This is the Super Mario Bros. Film. Had a pretty good time with it. Thought it was beautiful, but you know, pretty average in terms of like plot and everything. This is Super Pets, DC Super Pets. Trainspotting on 4K. Not necessarily needing of a 4K, but I'm glad I have it. I really enjoy the two Trainspotting films. Tar, Kate Blanchett. This is the Steelbook to the Ten Commandments. I got the Steelbook over like the regular slip because the Steelbook has the 1923 version. I think the hype sticker says it. Yeah, so it includes the 1923 version. And then this is the film from the 50s. Same director for both. That's kind of crazy. This is Christopher Nolan's Tenet. We have a couple of the Terminator films, Terminator Genesis and Terminator Dark Fate. I do not have T2 on 4K because I've heard enough bad reviews about that. So hopefully before I die, they can remaster that. But I know James Cameron is a little too busy with Avatar films at the moment, so we'll see if that ever becomes a thing. This is the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, just the regular slipcover version. This is The Thing. Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri. I believe this guy has a spine slash on it. So, yeah. So, I just display the other side. To Kill a Mockingbird. Nice, like, matte slipcover on this. Or, like, soft touch almost. Really enjoy the packaging on that. This is Tomb Raider. Tomb Raider, The Cradle of Life. Both starring Angelina Jolie. Then we have our Top Gun films. The first. And then Maverick. Probably my favorite film of 2022. And a great 4K disc to boot. All right, we're getting there. Stay with me. All right, we're getting there. We're in our final row here in terms of alphabetical order 4K releases. So starting things off in this row, we have Total Recall. Another 4K upgrade. This is The Town. Pretty hard slipcover to find for whatever reason that is. This is Train to Busan. And its sequel, Peninsula. Training Day, which got released earlier this year on 4K finally. And then we have all the Transformers films individually. 2007, this is Transformers Revenge of the Fallen. Transformers The Dark Moon. Transformers Age of Extinction. And then Transformers The Last Night. This is Hitchcock's The Trouble with Harry. The Unbearable Weight of Massive Talent. Unbreakable, Uncharted, Unforgiven, Untouchables, This is Us from Jordan Peele, V for Vendetta, Van Helsing. This will be my first time watching Vanilla Sky whenever I break this open on 4K. I've not seen it yet, but love Tom Cruise, Lisa's films. This is Vertigo. And this is the last little section right here before boutique and all that interesting stuff. So we got War Dogs right here. Love the artwork on this. I've always been drawn to this artwork. Same guy who did, you know, Hangover films and now onto The Joker and its sequel. Todd Phillips, I believe. This is The War of the Worlds, the Steven Spielberg version. Warcraft. Warrior, Watchmen, West Side Story, Widows, Steelbook 4 Whiplash, The Witch, The Wizard of Oz, The Wolf of Wall Street, The Woman King, It's a Wonderful Life, The World's End, Zero Dark Thirty, and then of course Zombieland 1 and Zombieland 2. All right, that was a big milestone. Just got through all the alphabetical releases. Beyond that, it kind of gets chaotic. You know, I have some Blu-rays down here. I have my alphabetical Blu-rays. I got some Studio Ghibli and then other G-Kids down here, some other anime. But as we go further down, we do eventually get some 4Ks. I'm literally sitting on my butt to do this. So leave a like for sitting on your butt. Thanks. All right, so here's Criterion. We got some 4K sprinkled throughout. So Time Bandits just got released on 4K. So we do have that. For All Mankind, this is a documentary. Just picked that up on 4K, found it used. We have Le Cercle Rouge, or The Red Circle in English. That's on 4K. Let's see here. Dazed and Confused is still the old Blu-ray copy. Hate to say it, this is Blowout. Definitely have this one on 4K. I bought this like right before they released it on 4K. So these are still the Blu-rays of the three-color trilogy. Hard Day's Night. Yeah, so some of these I need to pull out the other way because that's the way the spine goes. But yeah, it's a 4K copy, Hard Day's Night. Fisher King, this will be the other way. That's on 4K. Let's see here. Night of the Living Dead. This will be broken open this upcoming Halloween time for sure. I'll definitely upgrade the Princess Bride. This is only the Blu-ray as of now, but I will get the 4K of some sort at some time. Jesus. All right. This is a slew of 4Ks right here. This is like when they first started doing it, the Criterion Collection. So we got Uncut Gems. This is, gonna play this game the whole time. This is Citizen Kane. This is Menace to Society. This is Double Indemnity, probably the best film noir I've ever seen. Such a good film. This is Shaft. This is Okja. Raging Bull, Devil in a Blue Dress, starring Denzel Washington. Sound of Metal, also such a great film. The Power of the Dog. This is Malcolm X, definitely on 4K. This is Wall-E, got that one on 4K. My only duplicate, like I have, of course, Wall-E right here from the Criterion Collection. But I can't throw away this one because it just looks so good. You know, it's like the only like deep purple slipcover of like this whole thing. So that's like the only duplicate I ever really intend on keeping because they kind of fit in both places, spine number wise. And then, you know, Pixar release order is what it is. That's the struggle of collecting, ain't it? This is Triangle of Sadness on 4K. This is Thelma and Louise. Recently released on 4K, picked that up during the last sale along with After Hours. So I think those are all my Criterion Collection 4Ks. Those are just, you know, kind of interspersed throughout wherever they end up with spine number wise. Over here is Arrow Video. This is the replacement disc for Donnie Darko, which we will go over soon, but I think there's a disc problem with the sealed version I have. So this is 12 Monkeys on 4K. This is Hugo, recently released on 4K. I don't remember if these are 4K. So this is Battle Royale. 4K Ultra HD. 4K Ultra HD. Thank goodness. That is 4K. So we do have that. This is Dune, the cool slip box set for the first film. And we have that for Donnie Darko as well. Also on 4K. And then I was so close to picking up RoboCop on standard Blu-ray, but then they announced a 4K. So I held off. And will be picking up, or I did pick up the 4K version. I think the only, like, well, there's probably a few that I want, but one that I'm definitely getting after is Waterworld
in like the 4K cool thick box set version.
So one day I'll get Waterworld. All right, these are my Kino Lorbers. I think all of my Kino Lorbers are indeed in 4K. So this is the score. There really aren't any sort of order, at least not right now. This is the original Mad Max. So I do have all Mad Max films in 4K. This is Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind. I don't know if I ever said Italian Job. This is the Italian Job for sure, the original. In Bruges, such a good film. The Apartment, can say the same thing. Touch of Evil, I just realized these are all good films, so I really won't denote them that way. Invasion of the Body Snatchers, Tropic Thunder, Spaceballs, A Fistful of Dollars, For a Few Dollars More, and The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, The Man with No Name trilogy. And then my only Vinegar Syndrome release that I have is Cloak and Dagger, but like, the packaging for Vinegar Syndrome releases is just absolutely outstanding. You get this fantastic artwork, and then in here is like a whole, you know, box with a bunch of goodies, and then this is like the film with like a cool embossed spot glossed slip cover on it. Like, it's just the care and packaging and stuff is so awesome. So if there's a film that you like on 4K, or you know, getting the box set treatment from Vinegar Syndrome, bro, like, pick it up. Like, this is some of the best packaging that I've ever seen from any boutique label, you know, let alone like standard labels and stuff. Like, Vinegar Syndrome knows what they're up to. They have a super cool like wraparound artwork, super awesome. So yeah, super happy with that release. All right, last but not least, I'm gonna go to the top floor. Up here, I do have some 4Ks, really just in this section. Actually, I lied. I'll just kind of go over whatever I got here. So this is the original, I believe, unaltered versions of the original trilogy, Star Wars, of course, I'm talking about, on VHS. So one day I'll get a VHS player and I'll watch them unedited, because I've never seen them unedited before. These are some A24 shop exclusives, all on 4K, all on these, all like really tall flipping cases that don't fit anywhere. This is The Last Black Man in San Francisco. This is Midsummer, the director's cut. All of these are on 4K, like I said. This is The Lighthouse. Oh, it's the best way, yeah, just that, huh? The Lighthouse. This is The Green Knight. I will likely pick up Everything Everywhere All at Once, just because I'm kind of a completionist. But they're releasing banger films on this format. It's not like, you know, they're just doing all their films. They're releasing some of their best. So I do appreciate that. Kind of respecting collectors in that way. Like completionists, I should say. This is Marcel, The Shell with Shoes On. I absolutely love this film. I had such a good time with it when I watched it. Just kind of keep it up here with the A24, even if it's not like the tall boy versions. Got Indiana Jones, just the trilogy, that's VHS. Got another Star Wars, I think that's DVD. Got the Dark Knight box set, super, super cool. Here's my, I think this is the last 4K in this whole video. That is Back to the Future trilogy. You just have that up there. Behind that is a Matrix box set. We got The Office, you know, I'm just kind of showing everything at this point. This is Adventure Time. These are just all films that I'm selling right now. Kind of just keep them up in that corner. And then, you know, now I think about it, down here is the last bit of 4K that I earn, or that I own, right next to my only HD DVD. Gotta love that. This is the Columbia Classics box set that has, you know, whatever, these six films in it, all on 4K, still sealed. I will probably not keep this. I'll probably sell it. I love The Social Network. That's probably in my top 10 in terms of all movies, but I think the Blu-ray is absolutely fine. Does it justice. Don't necessarily need the 4K upgrade on that. But I do own it for now, so it does deserve a spot in this video. And that is my entire 4K Ultra HD collection as of now, September 2023. It's somewhere close to 600 in terms of like individual movies that I have right now. Super proud of it. I'm gonna keep on collecting. They're
just keep announcing stuff every single week. So definitely hyped up about that. Are there any other collections you want me to go through? I mean, I do have, you know, standard Blu-rays and stuff, but I don't consider those super, super interesting to go through. But if I get enough requests for it, I will have considerably less Blu-ray than 4K. I started collecting, you know, less than, a little more than 2 years ago at this point. So 4K was already like well on its way. So if a film was available, I just got the 4K because I didn't want to have to upgrade it down the line and stuff. So I'm pretty fortunate that I didn't start collecting 10 years ago or 20 years ago, you know, respect to those people, but I kind of have it easy. So I have way more 4K than Blu-ray at the moment. That's just kind of the way it is. But you know, I do have a huge G-Kids collection. My Studio Ghibli collection is complete. If anyone, you know, ever wants to see those individually, I do have quite a few Criterion. Kind of went through all my Kino Lorber because I have only 4Ks for those. Same thing with Arrow Video. But yeah, I have a bunch of that. And then I also do have vinyl records. I'll probably just, even if I have no interest in that, I'll probably do a vinyl record collection, at least starting with movie soundtracks, because, you know, a lot of people who like physical, you know, Blu-rays and 4Ks and stuff, they like vinyl records of movie soundtracks too. So I'll definitely do a video pertaining to that sometime in the near future. It won't be a year long wait like last time. I can promise you that. But yeah, some point down the line, I'll probably do that. And then if I have interest for like my general music collection, I can do that too. But just huge thank you if you made it to the end of this video. What titles do you have that I should get in my collection? And then what are titles that you're kind of curious about? Like, oh, is this really good? Or do you really like the packaging on this? You know, or is the transfer good? Ask me any questions down below. Let's have a conversation. Thanks for collecting physical media. I'm gonna keep doing it. Hope you keep doing it too. And once again, just thank you for watching. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day, week, morning, night, whenever you are watching this. And I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace out. Thank you.